So this biggest interview in this poll season, the man spearheading the BJP's 2024 campaign, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, spoke exclusively to India today. He reiterated the 400 par war cry. Prime Minister Narendra Modi made it very clear that the BJP's target is actually becoming a reality. Now, amidst this big reservation showdown, the Prime Minister also made it clear that the BJP will ensure that there is no religion-based quota and that there will be no going against the Constitution of India. The Prime Minister targeted the opposition and the Congress in particular. He targeted the Gandhi family, saying that they harbored hatred towards the Indian Army for the 1962 debacle under Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's leadership of the country.
तीन चरणों के चुनाव हो चुके हैं, चौथे चरण के लिए आज मतदान है। उत्तर प्रदेश और बिहार में जो आपको समर्थन मिल रहा है, इसको आप भविष्य में एनडीए के लिए कैसा देखते हैं?
मैं साफ देख रहा हूं कि देश की जनता के लिए 400 पार ये नारा नहीं है, 400 पार ये हकीकत है। पहले तीन चरण में साफ हो चुका है, आज चौथे चरण का मतदान चल रहा है और मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि लोग, गर्मी कितनी ही क्यों ना हो, देश का भविष्य सुनिश्चित करने के लिए प्रतिबद्ध हैं और ऐसे सभी प्रतिबद्ध नागरिक अवश्य ही मतदान करेंगे, पक्का करेंगे और भारतीय जनता पार्टी और एनडीए की एक मजबूत सरकार फिर से बनाएंगे।
सर, कई विपक्षी दल ये कह रहे हैं कि 400 सीटें एनडीए को नहीं आएंगी, भारतीय जनता पार्टी को जो है 370 सीटें नहीं आएंगी। राहुल गांधी ने एक चुनावी सभा में ये कह दिया कि इस बार प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जो हैं वो 24 में पीएम नहीं बनेंगे, इसको किस प्रकार देखते हैं?
दो चीजों को दो हिस्से करते हैं। अब तक वो ये कह रहे थे कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी 400 पार नहीं कर पाएगी और मैं उनकी इस चर्चा का स्वागत करता हूं, क्योंकि उनको ये लग रहा है हो सकता है 399 हो, उनको लगता है हो सकता है 398 हो, इसलिए उनका भी बेंचमार्क 400 है, हमारा भी बेंचमार्क 400 है और हमको लगता है हम 400 पार करेंगे, वो कहते हैं 400 पार नहीं करेंगे, तो इतना ही फर्क है।
ये कह रहे हैं विपक्ष की 400 सीटें आ जाएंगी तो आप संविधान बदल देंगे, और दूसरी तरफ लालू यादव कह रहे हैं कि मुसलमानों को जो है वो पूरा आरक्षण मिलना चाहिए, इसको किस तरीके से आप देखते हैं?
देखिए, पहली बात ये है कि '19 से '24 हमारे पास 400 सीट थी, 360 के करीब हम जीत करके आए थे और एनडीए प्लस कहे तो हमारे पास 400 हमेशा रही है। तो सीट आने से संविधान बदल जाते हैं, ये तर्क गलत है। संविधान के साथ धोखा इस परिवार ने किया है। संविधान बनने के बाद सबसे पहले संविधान बदला पंडित नेहरू ने। उन्होंने क्या किया, सबसे पहले उन्होंने, पंडित नेहरू ने संविधान संशोधन किया और क्या किया, फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच को रिस्ट्रिक्ट किया। फिर इनकी बेटी आई इंदिरा जी, इंदिरा जी ने क्या किया, आपातकाल लगा दिया, कोर्ट के जजमेंट को उन्होंने नकार दिया, उनका चुनाव रद्द हो चुका था। संविधान के साथ धोखा उन्होंने किया। फिर उनके बेटे आए राजीव गांधी जी, उन्होंने क्या किया, उन्होंने आकर के भारत के मीडिया को कंट्रोल करने के लिए एक बिल लाए। देश के मीडिया ने और देश के विपक्ष ने बहुत बड़ा हल्ला किया तो बच गए, लेकिन तब वो संविधान की भावना के खिलाफ करने गए। उनके बेटे शहजादे, उन्होंने क्या किया, संविधान की कोख से जन्मी हुई सरकार होती है और सरकार की कैबिनेट वो संविधान के अधिष्ठान पर होती है, कैबिनेट ऐसी हवा में नहीं होती, वो कैबिनेट जो निर्णय करे वो संविधान से सुसंगत होता है। उस कैबिनेट के निर्णय किया डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह जी के लिए, इन्होंने प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस बुला करके उस कैबिनेट में जो निर्णय किया गया था उसके लीरे लीरे उड़ा दिए। मतलब वो एक कागज नहीं फाड़ रहे थे, भारत के संविधान के टुकड़े कर रहे थे। वो बाबा साहब आम्बेडकर की पीठ में छुरा भोंक रहे थे। वो भारत के संविधान निर्माताओं की भावनाओं को चूर चूर कर रहे थे। परिवार की सभी पीढ़ियों के सभी मुखियाओं ने संविधान के साथ ये बदतमीजी की है, उनको संविधान शब्द बोलना भी उनके मुंह में पाप लगता है। जहां तक भारतीय जनता पार्टी का सवाल है, हमारा कमिटमेंट है, हम एससी एसटी ओबीसी धर्म के आधार पर आरक्षण नहीं देंगे, नहीं होने देंगे। भारत के संविधान ने एससी एसटी ओबीसी को आरक्षण दिया हुआ है। संविधान की मूल भावना के खिलाफ हम होने नहीं देंगे। दूसरा, संविधान सभा की भावना थी कि वो किसी भी हालत में वे धर्म के आधार पर देश में आरक्षण स्वीकार नहीं करेंगे। बाबा साहब आम्बेडकर का मत था कि संविधान में धर्म के आधार पर आरक्षण नहीं हम रख सकते हैं। तो जो बाबा साहब आम्बेडकर ने कहा, जो संविधान सभा ने कहा, जिसके प्रति हमारी श्रद्धा है, हम उसको बरकरार रखने के लिए मेहनत कर रहे हैं। लेकिन जैसे वो पिक पॉकेटर होता है ना, वो किसी का जेब काटता है फिर चिल्लाता है, अरे वो चोर चोर चोर, और कोई दूसरा भागता है और ये माल लेकर के फिर धीरे से निकल जाता है। तो ये लोग चिल्ला इसलिए रहे हैं कि उनके इरादा है कि धर्म के आधार पर आरक्षण करने का, और इसलिए वो चिल्ला रहे हैं जी, और हम ये होने नहीं देंगे। चलिए, बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद
सर। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर भैया, आपने आज तक के लिए इतना समय दिया दर्शकों के लिए अपने व्यस्त समय में से। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
So multiple headline points in what Prime Minister Narendra Modi said, but scathing in his attack on the Congress party. Joining me on this special broadcast is Sanju Verma, spokesperson of the BJP. Tehsin Poonawala is a political analyst, will give us the Congress perspective. Rajat Sethi is a political commentator. So is Ashutosh, author and political analyst, was earlier with the Aam Aadmi Party. And Ashutosh, I want to begin by asking you, sir. The Prime Minister has taken this 400 par constitution to be changed point that the opposition raises right to the opposition camp, says it's the Congress party that has repeatedly attacked the constitution from Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru to Rahul Gandhi. He's taken the war into the opposition camp, sir Ashutosh.
No, Gaurav, I had seen this interview at many times and I could see only that Prime Minister was very defensive and he was trying to answer the question which has been raised by the opposition. In fact, in this entire interview, in fact, in the last 3-4 interviews which I have watched and witnessed, I could not see that the Prime Minister is setting any agenda for the nation. And that's one of the shortcomings of this election, because Mr. Modi is known to set an agenda. You look at 2014, there was a national agenda. In 2019, there was a national agenda. This time, he's shifting goalposts. He started with Ram Mandir, then he started with guarantee. And then he committed the biggest mistake of his life, and that he started commenting on the constitution of the manifesto of the Congress party. And that was a trap, and he fell into that. Even this interview also, he was trying to answer the question that the BJP is not going to change the constitution because he knows the alignment of the Dalits and the Ambedkarites with the constitution is very strong, and it will really damage the party.
Fair enough. But has he taken the battle to the Congress camp, where he says it's the Congress that has repeatedly targeted the constitution? But responds Sanju Verma, Ashutosh says that the Prime Minister was very defensive in that interview to Aaj Tak, to India Today.
You know, Ashutosh and me, we have been on a several, we've been on several debates in the last couple of months. And I remember, Gaurav, with offense to none, that even prior to Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh and Telangana election results coming out, Ashutosh dhanke ki chot par, seema taan kar ye kehte the, you know, chahe suraj east se uge na uge aur west mein ast ho na ho, but double engine sarkar nahi banegi is baar. And look what happened. BJP got more than 160 seats in Madhya Pradesh. He was saying the law and order situation in Ashok Gehlot government crumbling is just a figment of BJP's wild imagination. And look what happened. Ashok Gehlot was shown the door. He said, Chhattisgarh mein toh dobara Bhupesh Baghel will come back to power with a thumping majority. And, you know, I'm not going to pull back my punches. Ashutosh had a nice big fat omelette on his face after Bhupesh Baghel was also shown the door, with the tribal population clearly telling that Baghel had failed them in no uncertain terms. Point number one. Point number two. You know, I just want to say this. For people who say, oh, PM was defensive, oh, BJP spokesperson is aggressive. You know, are you telling us ki aap Modi ji ko galiyan dete rahoge, aap Amit Shah ko galiyan dete rahoge, you will start screaming caste census, you will say hum Dalito ka, Adivasiyo ka, Arakshan lekar Musalmano ko dete rahenge, but you expect that the Prime Minister will keep it zipped. No, I'm sorry, that's not going to happen.
Okay.
Because Article 19 ke tahat jo freedom of expression Gaurav Sawant ko hai, Sanju Verma ko hai, Ashutosh ko hai, the same freedom of expression is something that Prime Minister Narendra Modi also enjoys.
Fair enough, so you're saying he wasn't on the defensive? But is he setting the agenda or not setting the agenda, as Ashutosh says? But since you said Ashutosh had egg on his face in previous elections, Ashutosh, you raised your finger. You want to quickly respond to that, sir? And on the point that the Prime Minister or the BJP says it's the Congress that raises the bogey of constitution change, whereas it's the Congress that has actually toyed or played with the constitution repeatedly. Ashutosh. Sir, you're on mute.
I like it when Sanju Verma says I have an egg on my face, because I really like to eat eggs and I really feed on eggs. So I have nothing to worry about it. Thank God she didn't say that the omelette on my face. The fact of the matter is that look at the irony of this, because I really admire Prime Minister, because he has a charisma and he really weaves narrative. But this time, why he need to react on the Congress manifesto? On this allegation, this accusation that the BJP, if gets more than 400 seats, then the BJP will change the constitution.
Okay.
Why he's going back to Jawaharlal Nehru? Why he's going back to Indira Gandhi? Why he's going back to Rajiv Gandhi? The issue is the BJP has failed to set an agenda and narrative. Last time, you remember in 2019, that is the Prime Minister's narrative and the opposition was reacting.
Okay.
This time, it's opposition's narrative and the BJP is reacting. That's irony.
Fair enough. Rajat Sethi, is that how you see this? That the Prime Minister or the BJP is only reacting to a narrative that's being set by the Congress party, and the BJP is not setting the agenda, or the Prime Minister is not setting the agenda for this election?
I think, neutrally speaking, what the Prime Minister said is the exact agenda setting which BJP has been successfully doing for several decades now. BJP has consistently been saying that Congress's intentions have to be questioned, because they have never, succeeded when it came to holding power. They have never respected the constitution. These anecdotes from the history are clear reflection of how much amount of commitment they have on the constitution that they keep flashing every other day. So I think BJP is bang on the agenda. This is their agenda, to discredit Congress party, to continue to discredit, showcase what they did when they had power in hand, showcase what Rahul Gandhi used to respect the institution of the Prime Minister, show what kind of a bratty attitude he had. The current generation, the Gen Z, doesn't remember the UPA days. They were not even born or mature enough to understand what UPA entailed.
Okay.
It is the job of the BJP and Prime Minister Modi to reiterate it. And that is their agenda. That is their core agenda. And
Tehsin, I think
Prime
Poonawala
Minister is not shifting even an inch away from that agenda. It could be to Ashutosh's liking or disliking, I don't know.
Okay.
But the problem with Ashutosh's analysis is that in every line that Prime Minister speaks, he wants to find a small hair of argument that there is something that the confidence of Prime Minister is shaking. Somehow he is losing. Ashutosh ji, how many debates do you want to get defeated on by constantly trying to say that there is something happening and BJP is somehow coming below the majority mark? Sir, these arguments do
sir,
not
stick. We'll know that on the 4th of June for sure. But the other point that the Prime Minister raised, that the Congress carries a chip on its shoulder, the 1962 debacle under Pandit Nehru, and that is why the Congress is repeatedly targeting the armed forces. Tehsin Poonawalla, the Prime Minister's point is that the Gandhi family is very worried that Indira Gandhi's stature will come down, Rajiv Gandhi's stature will come down, because in case Narendra Modi were to become the Prime Minister in 2024, then he'll only be the second person after Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and that is something that the Congress is very upset about.
Good evening, Gaurav. Thank you so much for having me on the show. Now, I can't help what the Honorable Prime Minister thinks or likes to live in a make-believe world. People have credit cards, debit cards. If the BJP has a victim card, it's not my fault. They can live with the victim card. I'm happy with my credit and debit card. The point is this. This is the greatest country in the world, Gaurav, and we all both agree on it. And the greatest country in the world, you've been Prime Minister for 10 years, two times Prime Minister with an absolute majority. There's nothing more any man can want than being Prime Minister. But to come down to a phenomenal channel like Aaj Tak and Musalman, Pandit Nehru, Rajiv Gandhi, Indira Gandhi, bhaiya, aap batao na, aap 10 saal mein kya kya, aap 5 saal mein aage karoge kya? To continuously just play victim. After you've got everything, this country is giving you everything. What more can this country give Prime Minister Modi? Kya Musalman hamare nahi? Musalman, ghuspaitiya, Mangal Sutra, machhi. Ye koi baat hoti karne ki? Muslim League. आप बताओ आप क्या करोगे अगले 5 साल में Gen Z, how will you change their lives? That's the first part. Second part, let me come to you. Yes, there was a debacle against China. But under the same Indira Gandhi, we defeat China at Nathula and Chola. I have so much respect for your father. You're a veteran. You know in military history, we defeated China. You know about Operation Falcon against China, Arunachal Pradesh. Rajiv Gandhi declared it Arunachal state. You know what happened. Look, this is not... We are one country, right? No Prime Minister will want our country down. Not even Prime Minister Modi will want our country down. Why would you tarnish somebody who's a martyr for the country? Rahul Gandhi ki nani bhi constitution ne bantha ki kya hai ye?
Okay, aap batao, Sanju Varma wants to quickly respond. So Tehsin Poonawalla specifically refers to 1967 at Nathula, where India gave China a bloody nose. He also refers to Sundarong Chu in 1986-87, where once again there was a 5-year-long standoff, but China had to bend. So Sanju Varma, the Congress Party's supporter, is raising that point. Why tarnish Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, or Rahul Gandhi? The three of them, I mean, three, Pandit Nehru, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, not there to defend themselves.
You know, Gaurav, let me play the victim card today for a change. Since Tehsin has said that, you know, the Prime Minister plays victim card, on a lighter note today, I want to play the victim card on your show, Gaurav Sawan. I would just request you to give me as much time as Tehsin. First and foremost, you know, playing the victim card, let me lay down some facts on Gaurav Sawan's show, you know. Point number one, Tehsin made a very interesting point, you know, jo pichle 10 saalon mein kiya hai, uska व्याख्यान क्यों नहीं करते प्रधानमंत्री, उसका व्याख्यान भी होता है. एंड वेरी क्विकली आई विल टेक जस्ट 30 सेकंड्स टू टेल यू व्हाट प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी हैज डन इन वाराणसी, बिकॉज़ योर ऑडियंस नीड्स टू हियर दैट. 3.2 लाख टॉयलेट्स बिल्ट इन वाराणसी अलोन अंडर स्वच्छ भारत अभियान. 3.46 लाख टैप वाटर कनेक्शंस गिवन अंडर जल जीवन मिशन. 11.2 लाख आयुष्मान कार्ड्स गिवन टू पीपल विद इन वाराणसी रीजन अलोन. 71,000 beneficiaries of Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandan Yojana.
Okay.
102,000 farmers benefited in Varanasi alone from PM Kisan Samman Nidhi. 81,000 farmers got Kisan credit cards in Varanasi region alone.
As much time as was given to Tehsin Poonawalla.
I'm finishing. Gaurav, just two lines more.
Okay, two more lines, ma'am.
I just have this to say. But you know, who started, Gaurav, this entire narrative? Democracy khatre mein hai, loktantra khatre mein hai, ganatantra khatre mein hai. Are aapke Pradhan Mantri Nehru imprisoned Majru Sultanpuri for 6 months only because he dared to write some lyrics against the Nehru regime. And the 1975 emergency by Indira Gandhi is not lost on anyone.
Okay.
So the Prime Minister is only showing you the mirror. And if you don't like the ugly reflection, too bad. Learn to live with it.
Okay. So Ashutosh, the BJP insists that for Gen Z, it's facts being put out in public domain, you know, facts as the BJP sees them or as they exist. But the other point, Is there genuine worry that the Prime Minister's stature, if he were to become Prime Minister once again in 2024, would only be second to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru winning three elections? And is there merit in the BJP saying Nehru wasn't even elected, no general elections had happened when the First Amendment was brought in and the Constitution was changed, freedom of speech was curbed?
Gaurav, if Prime Minister gets a third term, who are we to question that? We live in democracy and we have to believe in it. But the fact of the matter is today, the data railed out by BJP spokesperson, if that has been truth, Prime Minister wouldn't have gone to the calling Congress manifesto, the Muslim League manifesto, wouldn't have talked about the buffaloes, about the cows and about Sharia laws and all that. And wouldn't have called Muslims as an infiltrator. The fact of the matter is that today the Prime Minister is not talking about...
No, I take strong objection. He's lying.
Okay, ma'am, let him complete his point and quickly come to you to rebut. Sanjeev
Verma, I still believe that you believe in the freedom of expression. I still believe that your party believes in the freedom of expression.
Let's go on, sir.
If I'm wrong, you disprove me. I'm not quarreling with you. But the issue is the Prime Minister, from Prime Minister to the Amit Shah to the to Yogi Adityanath, they are scaring Hindus of this country that if Congress will come to the power, there will be Sharia law. Can you imagine something like this? If they come to the power, the in Indian cricket team, sare jo hai wo kis part kis dharm ke log ho jayenge? Is it what we are talking about? This shows that the Prime Minister is nervous. BJP is nervous and not confident about it.
Okay, Rajat Sethi, quickly 30 seconds that I have on the show.
Can I quickly come in?
Can I quickly bring in Rajat Sethi? Does this show the BJP's nervousness when the Prime Minister says will not permit religion-based quota as it goes against the spirit of the Constitution?
Just today, Prime Minister has had 5-kilometer-long roadshow in Varanasi. If that doesn't give jitters to Congress party, it's an existential jitter. It's not a normal jitter Congress should be having right now. Look at the contrast. Contrast was Rai Bareilly, where mother, sister and brother took a charter flight, landed directly in Rai Bareilly and just handed over the nomination paper. This is the two contrasts of two Indias envisioned by two different set of leaders. One is a person who has risen up the ranks and the... That is based on his track record. Okay. And the other person's confidence is that he doesn't even know where to contest from. And on the day of the nomination, he has to literally rush around in a charter flight and just somehow submit the nomination papers. This is the commitment to the constituency that this family...
Okay, 2 seconds. Okay. Tehsin Poonawalla, one quick rebut. Tehsin Poonawalla, quickly, sir.
No, I'm very confused, Gaurav. Thoda sa mera confusion, aap dur kar dijiye. Ashutosh bhai, aap madad kijiye. Ye Modi ji Uber Ola mein gaye kya? Nomination charter flight mein nahi gaye kya? Uber Ola mein gaye. Ye koi topic hota hai India Today pe. Let's talk logically. Can I?
Okay, perhaps Rajat Sethi was trying to draw the parallel between the difference in the two roadshows. Okay, 30 seconds. 30 seconds, Sanjeev Verma. 30 seconds.
Gaurav, you know, amidst the din of, what various panelists are saying, let us not forget one very important point. In the first 67 years of post-independent India, 54 years it was the Congress which ruled, and in those 54 years, it was 143 occasions that duly elected governments were dismissed. Out of those 143 occasions, 102 times it was the Congress Prime Ministers which dismissed duly elected governments. And guess what? Who dismissed duly elected governments 49 times?
Well, so it's for the voters in the remaining three phases to decide who they think is better. I'm sorry I've run out of time on this part of the show.